Notice when you did the INT S0, that prompt change, what mode would that be? Interface configuration. That's a sub that, you know, we said global config was the config prompt. This would be a sub mode underneath global. We're specifically in interface mode. Pull up a chair.
Okay, then you did INT.
INTSO.
Okay. So, okay. I thought I put in host name San Jose.
Yeah.
And I didn't get anything. I tried to get
Now, y'all practice, after you get this in here, y'all practice going in and changing things and finding your way around the iOS. Yeah. Yeah. Press the enter key. All right, see where your prompt is at? You're going to type in enable. Oh, that's I'm sorry, show interface? That's the shortcut for show interface.
Oh.
So you can either do show interface or you can do S-H-I-N-T. Now, read what's on your screen and see if you can make any sense of it. Okay, look at your sheet, especially you, Chris, since you're at this point. You see where you did no shut?
Yeah.
Y'all know what no shut means? Got any idea? No shutdown means bring it up. Interfaces on routers are down or are considered to be administratively down by default. So anytime you're programming a router and you're putting an IP address on an interface, you have to type the no shut command. No shut takes it out of administratively down into an up state. And when you get to the bottom where you do show interfaces, you're always going to look for your interface to say line protocol up, interfaces up. Six what?
Six lost carrier is what it says.
Don't know what that
after
means.
After show interfaces.
It says zero babble, zero late collision, zero difference, six lost carrier, zero no carrier.
Oh yeah, you don't worry about that right now because we're not physically plugged up to a network, but when we do get physically connected to a network. All right, I'm gonna show y'all another command that you're gonna use a lot. When you did show interfaces, that showed you all the information that you typed into that interface to program it. Notice my prompt up here. Here's another test question. How many layers in down into the iOS am I? My prompt is config IF. I am from privilege to config to interface mode, right? I'm three layers down. Watch what happens when I type in exit. How many layers down am I now?
Two.
Two layers down. Okay, this is what we're doing right here is simple. You're gonna get five and six layers down and need to get back to privilege exec. Do you wanna type exit five or six times to get back to that point?
No.
Do control Z. That's another test question. Control Z. And it doesn't look like that command works on this simulator. But if you do Control Z.
It doesn't. Some of them, like I said, it'll work for me.
It did work for you?
You already exited. You have to be back to the config IF.
All right, let me go back into that. Control Z. Mine's not working. Must be my something on my keyboard. Well, there it is. I didn't push it hard enough. But Control Z takes you straight back to privilege, whereas exit takes you one layer at a time. Now, the other command I wanted to show you, you know the running configuration that we talked about right here? We're going to look at what is on that chip. And you're going to do that by typing in show run, which is show running configuration. And you should see in that configuration list everything that you typed in. And remember, space bar to go to the next screen. Look at my serial interface. I never finished programming mine. But mine is showing shutdown. So when y'all are physically cabling up a network and you're programming everything, and you're saying, oh, I can't ping my interface, one thing you're going to want to do is do show run to see if the interface is up and running. You can do show run to see the configuration that's on the NVRAM chip. Or you can do show interfaces. Incidentally, another important thing, the file, the physical configuration file that's saved on this chip right here is named by default startup config. When the iOS boots up, all right, we do post, like BIOS on the ROM chip, then it looks for the iOS. It's going to immediately go to NVRAM and look for a file named startup config. So that's a default file name. Now, have we saved our configuration? Right now, we are looking at running config. If we want to save this, we got to do copy, running config, space, startup config. Now, when you press enter, before you go further, you see it's something in brackets? Copy running dash config space startup config dash config, I'm sorry. This is very important. Startup config is in parentheses. You notice that? That is a default for the Cisco iOS. So it's saying, if you press enter here, I'm going to overwrite that default file name with what you just programmed. And I'm going to save it on this NVRAM chip. Y'all get it?
Yes.
All right, it's one other thing that we have not talked about, and we're going to talk more in depth about this later. Y'all know what an algorithm is? It's a series of instructions, right? If I said, get up out of your chair, walk towards the door, open the door, go down the hall, look for the water fountain, drink some water, come back. You know, if I gave you a series of steps like that, that's an algorithm. Okay, routers use their own algorithms to route packets. They are called routing protocols. There are four main routing protocols. They are RIP, RIP version 2, OSPF, and eGRIP. And I, what's the other one? iGRIP. I'm sorry, it's 5. These are individual routing algorithms. Okay, that router will not route unless you enable a routing protocol. How do you know which protocol to enable? You're going to learn that in semester 2 Cisco. But for now, we're going with the simple, basic one, which is RIP. That's why you did router RIP. Could you do router OSPF? Yes, type it in and see. Could you do...
After the startup one?
You would... in the sequence of commands, you would replace RIP with router OSPF. Without a interface that's up, it won't route. Without a configuration, it won't route. Without a routing protocol, it won't route. You remember when we did the we did some addressing last week, and I said that 192.168.5.0, I'm going to program that network, or you program the network here. Let's see, what was your network? You did two networks, 192.168.132. That's the same thing as a 192.168.1.0. We'll learn all about that when we do IP addressing. But that's saying everything underneath 192.168.1.32, every host that has an IP address underneath that, I'm routing for it. And I'm using the RIP algorithm, the RIP routing algorithm. Yeah, this is, on my example, anything between 33 and 62 will be routed based on one interface. And then everything, see where 64 is? 65 through 127 will be routed on another interface. That will all make sense when we do IP addressing. Okay. But let's pretend that we didn't, that's a subnetted network, in other words. If we didn't subnet this network, we would do 192, we would say network 192.168.1.0, and then everything from 1 down, the router would route for within that network. Does that help? If it has two physical interfaces.
So like the serial port would be one IP,
mm-hmm.
and the Ethernet would be another.
That's right. And they'd be on two different networks. And the reason is because when you connect two routers together, in order for those routers to exchange data packets, they go through a WAN link, which is a physical serial connection. And so you have to program that into an IP addressing scheme that those two can rationalize. And then you can have a router that has one interface, or you can have a router that has four interfaces. Every interface on that router is a subnetwork. That's why when we subnet networks, we can end up with ever how many subnetworks we have as far as interfaces go. Like this particular configuration indicates that we have two networks on here. So we would have two physical interfaces. Does that make sense?